Good evening, everybody. Master in Trading lesson number 6, risk management. This is our headquarters of Swissquote Bank. Swissquote Group is listed on the Swiss market exchange since May 2000. We have more than 24 billion of Swiss franc in assets under custody and more than 310,000 clients worldwide. So thank you. We are beyond the highest Swiss banking standard with the 26.1% capital ratio and 187.8 million of revenues last year in 2007. We started this mastering trading 5 lessons ago. I mean, one month ago, we have a weekly lesson, and you can find all the recording in our YouTube channel. So you just have to go on YouTube and search for Swissquote. You will find the playlist of mastering trading in English and then also in other languages. If you want to learn a new language, you can do also with our courses. Speaking about trading, maybe it is a good idea, probably. This is MetaTrader 4 and 5 that are integrated with our liquidity. A lot of brokers, they offer MetaTrader platform, but the technology, the investment we do is completely different, because I already explained different times the advantages of using Swissquote with the 17 liquidity providers that we have. So we have a lot of liquidity, and the execution is very fast and precise. So this is very important when it comes to trade. You can also use the direct access to the MetaTrader signals, and all the expert advisors are accepted with us. We are proud sponsor of Manchester United, and we tend to create the optimal environment for your success. Take the lead. This is me. I'm education manager for Swissquote Bank, and I'm member of the International Federation of Technical Analysts and the Italian Society of Technical Analysis. And usually, a lot of television, they invite me to their program, so maybe sometimes I say something that is interesting, they go ahead to invite me, so this is good for me. I think that also during the webinars, you find them very interesting. So for this reason, you're following every single webinar. Thank you very much again. You can find here our content. So usually I put this slide at the end of the presentation, but I think that is very useful to put at the beginning of the presentation, because I also know that on YouTube channel, the average of people that are looking at the first minutes of the presentation is much higher than the people that are looking at the end of the presentation. So for this reason, I put our contact forest.support@swissquote.com. Also, if you want to have the recording maybe of the last presentation, because you are not finding them on YouTube, it is very easy. You just have to go on YouTube and find for Swissquote. But you never know what can happen in life. So if you need more information, you can contact us at this email, forest.support@swissquote.com, or dial the number +41 44 825 8777. Swissquote.com is our website. Today's agenda: how to manage the risk of a single position, a single trade, and this is very important, the new feature trade terminal of that we offer on MetaTrader platform, MetaTrader 4 platform. Okay, you will enjoy this new software tonight. And then you can ask for this software, if you use our MetaTrader, to our forex.support@swissquote.com email. Okay, so you will just need to install the software onto your MetaTrader 4 platform. Okay, so it will be a new software that we offer for you. Then we will be looking at the high exposure indicator in MetaTrader platform that is very easy to understand and to use. We already spoke about margin call and stop out in the first lesson of mastering trading, but when we come to speak about risk management, of course, you have to understand where the stop out of the broker it is. And some tips in order to understand how to manage your stop loss. So I use average true range and standard deviation indicator. You know, standard deviation is very famous in trading. It's a statistical indicator, it's a statistical formula, but in trading it is very famous, standard deviation, thanks to the Bollinger Bands. So we will speak a little bit about these two indicators, average true range and Bollinger Bands. And the last point is very important, is how to manage the risk of the whole portfolio. MetaTrader platform, both MT4 and MT5, they really help on this, because they have the exposure tab that we will be displaying at the end of this presentation. So stay tuned till the end. Okay, so this is the first thing that I would like to show you, the new tool that we offer. Okay, so thanks to our MT4, then you just have to write to forest.support@swissot.com in order to get these tools. You can use this tool both in the demo platform and in the real account, of course. So if you want to try before in the demo platform, please feel free to ask to my colleague writing at the address I show you different time, forest.support@swissot.com. But in order to explain you this new tool that we offer that is very good in order to monitor the risk of the single position, I really love to go straight to the point using the tool directly. So I switch now to the MT4, Swissquote MT4. So after that, you just install this software, you will find some indicators, a lot of indicators, not some, more, Swissquote bar charger and all the others. Also tonight, for example, those two indicators that you see here in this chart are the Duncan indicator and the Renko indicator. We already spoke a little bit about these strategies two webinars ago in the lesson number 4, but also tonight I will do some example of risk management directly here from the chart, so we have time later to discuss a little bit about these technical settings. Anyway, what I want to show you now is if you open the Expert Advisor after having installed the tool. The name of the tool is Swissquote tool. So you just have to ask to my colleague writing to forest.support@swissquote.com this new tool that we offer, and you can integrate into your MT4 downloaded by swissquote.com website. You have several expert advisors, but those expert advisors are not a trading system. Our expert advisor, because if you want to send order to the market, in MetaTrader, you need to have an expert advisor. Okay, so all these expert advisors that you see here are not trading system, are software programs. For example, this is a software about the correlation. This is the trade terminal that I want to show you now. So you just have to use the auto trading. You have to switch it on. Okay, so you have to enable just pressing this button. Now it's red, it's disabled. Now it's green, it's enabled. Okay, and then you just have to drag and drop the trade terminal into the chart. Okay, I already did before, so I don't do twice. You can enable the connect. This is very good to have the connect, Swissquote connect, this first. When you open the platform, you find a lot of interesting news. You find the calendar of the day. We already spoke about this in the lesson number 3 or 4. So you just take your time in order just to install this into your platform, and then it's very easy to understand. So you have the news of the day, the calendar, our market research, our education section, and our webinars calendar. So you can register to the next event from here. So for example, now I want to look at the next webinar that Swissquote is offering to me. So I just have to click on webinars, and then I have to click on education, and you will be finding all the calendar for the next lessons. Then you have our contacts, so for example here, and our Facebook and Twitter channel. This is from Connect, okay? Then let me go on the trade terminal section. And you have this view. So you have all the groups of MetaTrader 4 in the column. So if you want to add some products into your watch list, you can do. You have the watch list here. So I will go for the popular one. And then if you want, you can add more products from here. For example, now I want to go on the group of the CFD spot, for example. I already have some CFD spot on my watch list, but now I want to add the Nasdaq, for example. I just have to click here and then to select add to watch list and to add on to my watch list that is named popular. Okay, so I will be finding the Nasdaq here on my watch list. Okay, this is very easy. But what I really want to show you now, because now we are speaking about risk management, the problem is of MetaTrader platform is when you have the standard platform, you can buy or sell a number of contracts, but you cannot define previously the risk in term of money. Okay, in your MetaTrader 4 platform or MetaTrader 5 platform, maybe you can download some script that help you, some expert advisor or script or indicators. There are in the MetaQuotes market, but in the original version of MetaTrader, you don't have any tool in order to understand before you place the trade how much money you are risking for the single position. Okay, thanks to this new tool that Swissquote is offering you, if you install this onto your MetaTrader 4. This tool at the moment is working only on MetaTrader 4, that anyway is the most commonly used platform in the world for CFDs and Forex, so you can use MT4 in this case. What you can do, let's go on Euro dollar, for example, but be careful because now we have opened the trade terminal. Then we will see all these windows that we have in the watch list in the mini terminal. That is the same. I will explain the difference. The mini terminal is directly on the chart. The trade terminal is a sort of way to manage the portfolio overall. Okay, so we will start with the mini terminal. Before going to the mini terminal, I just want to show you this. That is very effective, very useful in my opinion. So this is your brand new account that you just opened today, for example. Okay, so then you click when you want, for example, here on balance. And directly from here, you can set some alarms, some alerts. Okay, you can even set alerts directly from the original MetaTrader. This is the original MetaTrader 4 integrated with our software. Okay, but in the MetaTrader 4, you can just set some alerts on prices only, as I show you in the lesson number 2. Okay, here you can add some more alarm on the balance, on the equity, on the floating profit and loss, and other useful, for example, pips in profit or pending orders. Let's go on the equity. This is very easy to understand. Let's say that now I have 10,000 euros, and I open some position, and I want to receive an alert by email if my balance will be going to 11,000. Okay, so maybe I will reset the email, then I'm doing my daily job. I just opened my mobile platform, or I just moved back to my desk, or I connect to my VPS, and then maybe I want to close the position, I want to manage the portfolio. So it is very useful to have this kind of alarm. And then maybe you want to repeat the alarm every minute or every 10 minutes or 1 hour. It's up to you. You have different opportunities. And then, yes, send me the email. But remember that you have to set up once the information. So you need to go on Tools, Options, and Notifications. And then you can, email, notification is on mobile email. And then you have to click on enable and then set up all the information, writing your server, and that's it. And then you will receive the mail when the condition will be reached. Be careful that, of course, this is obvious, you have to keep the platform open. If you set the alarm and then you switch off the platform and you switch off the computer, for example, of course, it is impossible to send the alarm because it's the computer, it's the software that is sending the alarm to you. Okay. Remember that in MetaTrader, when you want to set alarm, when you want to use the training stop, And when you want to use expert advisor trading systems, you need to keep the computer on. If not, you can use VPS or whatever, as we explained in the previous lesson, so I cannot say again the same things. Okay, I don't see any question via chat, so let me know if everything is clear so far, but I think it was very easy to understand so far. Eventually, what you can also do, if it is this, you can send me the email, but also you can close the orders. So if my balance will be greater than 11,000 euros, please close all the orders. Okay. And then save. You have to press save and keep the platform open. Okay. And now you see you have the arm here. So you can click then afterwards. If you want to amend something, if you want to change something, if you want to edit, if you want to modify. Okay. You can do directly from here. Or if you want to cancel, you just have to deselect this and then save or click on turn off. Okay, so you see, there is no more alarm here. This is very useful. This is also something related to money management, because if you are managing the understanding of how and when close the position, of course, I'm speaking about this this feature now during this webinar about risk management, because if you manage yourself and manage your time and you manage the way that you manage your portfolio, okay, of course, this is related to risk management, okay? And I think it is very good to know these things that are very helpful also in order to help you to trade better, because you cannot spend 24 hours a day in front of the computer. So having this kind of tool, in my opinion, is a life changer. This is a, I don't want to say that it's a life changer tool, but it helps a lot the quality of the daily life of a trader. Okay, let me know by chat if you agree with me or not. Next step, what I want to show you now is, let's go on the a mini terminal, okay? Yeah, the Connect Windows. Yeah, you need some memory busy in order to keep it open. So now I want to just to show you how the, let's go on a white chart, and then I want to explain you the mini terminal. I'm explaining the mini terminal now simply because the mini terminal is just the name of this box that you can see here in the upper right that you have in the trade terminal. But the difference, if you use the mini terminal, is that the trade terminal is a way to manage all the portfolio. If you open a chart, you just have to put the mini terminal on. And this is very, 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 very effective when you want to trade directly from the chart and at the same time, you want to manage the risk of the position directly here in a very easy way. So now I just want to show you this. Let's say that now I want to trade the euro dollar with a, I would say, short position. I have different possibilities. When you want to manage the risk of the portfolio, some people, a lot of traders, usually when you start to trade, you just buy or sell one lot, so, or 0.1 or 2 or 3, everyone has the number of lots that usually trades. Okay, that is not wrong at all. The point is that you have to be careful, because then you have to be careful relating to the money that you have onto your trading account and the availability of money that you have in general, okay, and the risk approach that you want to use in trading. Okay, so there is no an universal rule in order to have the best risk management, but you need to find the best rule that fit your lifestyle, I would say. Okay, so now, for example, I want to put to place a stop loss at this level. So I want to open a short position now, and then using this second icon, the crosshair, I go to the chart And I say, okay, now the price is 116.58, and I want to place my stop loss level above this resistance level that is 116.75. So 19 points above this level. So I will add some points more. So I want to place my stop loss at 22 pips, respect the actual price, the market price, okay? And then, of course, if it is a short position, you will click here on the bid price. If it is a long position, you will click here on the buy, okay, on the ask price. So these two, this difference is calculated by according to the position that you open. So to the bid or to the ask price, okay? And then what you cannot do directly on the MetaTrader without this tool, for example, is placing the trailing stop. If you want to use a trailing stop, here is very easy to do directly from this box. Okay, I think this is very, very helpful. Then I also want to put a take profit that is 44 pips, let's say, so the double of my stop loss. Do you know what is a trailing stop? We also explain what is a trailing stop and how to use trailing stop in MetaTrader in the lesson number 3 and 2, so in 2 lessons, and now again lesson number 6. But in this case, I'm showing you how to use the mini terminal of this expert advisor that you can use thanks to Swissquote. So trailing stop is a stop that is moving if the price is moving in your favor. So it is always important to remember that you have to insert the stop loss. And then if the price starts to move in your favor, the trailing stop will move the stop loss. Okay, so please remember to place your stop loss always. Okay, always, always, always. Now I would like to add this order, but I need to understand how many contracts, how many lots I want to sell. That is very important. So this is risk management. How many contracts you want to buy or sell, in this case selling. So I just have to hold my the control button, pressing the left button of the mouse. Okay, I want to show you again. Here, I go in the window here, okay? If you press Control and the left button of the mouse, you will have this new window, the web page dialog. This is very easy to use, and it will help you in order to calculate the lot size from the stop loss that you have placed, okay? So you have three solutions. The first is just typing the amount of money that you are willing to risk in this trade. And please remember that it's not always in euro, it's just in the base currency of your account. So if you have an account in euro, like in this case, there will be 250 euros. If you have an account in dollars, there will be $250. If you have an account in Turkish lira, there will be 250 Turkish lira. So you can write here what you want according to the base currency of your account, your trading account. So let's go for 20 or 250 or 1000. This is up to your how much you want to risk for this single trade. This is for your single trade, okay? The second and the third option that you have are very similar, okay? And let's say that I would like to risk the 2% of my account. And this 2%, if you write here, is based on the equity. If you write below, is based on the balance, okay? What is the difference between the equity? You can find this information also, of course, in the MetaTrader here. Let's say, then we'll make an example afterwards when we open these positions. But it is very easy to understand. Equity is the real value of the man, the real value of your account, including the position open. Okay. The balance in MetaTrader excludes the position open. So equity is equal to the balance plus your profit and loss at the moment. Okay? Then, if you want to risk 200 euros, why 200 euros? Simply because we are risking the 2% of the equity. The equity of this account is 10,000 euros, so the 2% is 200 euros. Okay? And then there is also another information that is the pip value per lot. As you know, with one contract, the pip value is 10 expressed in terms of the second currency. So they are $10, but this account is in euros, so $10 are expressed in euro, 8.58 with the price of the moment. So then there is another information more, another one information that the stop loss risk per the whole lot is 188 plus 71. This is information more that you don't need, but there is. So you need to, if you want to risk the 2% of the equity of your account, you need to open the position with the price of the moment with 1.06 lots. Then I want to short to open the position selling the euro dollar, so I just have to click here on sell. Okay? Please remember that this is changing the color if the price is moving up or down. So if the last tick of the movement was bearish, the color of the price is red. If not, will become green if the market is if the price moved up. Okay? Then if you can click here, set lots. In this case, I did it manually, but if you want to do from here, yeah, it's better. Let's do the example. Set. You just have to click set lots, and then you see 106. Okay, but I did manually, so it's the same. Okay, thank you for the confirmation. Do you have any question on this? I just see confirmation on the chat, so everything is clear so far. Let me also know about the quality of the sound, the quality of everything. Let me know if you have any curiosity about this tool. And what I really want to be sure is that you fully understand that this tool that is the Swissquote mini terminal that you can just drag and drop on the chart is easy to understand, easy to use, and it will also sort out the problem that we have sometimes. Okay, yeah, but if I want to risk 57 pips on the dollar yen, and I have an account in euro, how many lots I should buy or sell? In this case, you just have to fill in this very easy to use and understand expert advisor that is the Swissquote mini terminal that you can find, that you can ask to my colleague writing to forex.support@swissquote.com. And you will be receiving the installation file by email from my colleague, and then you can use directly from the MetaTrader 4 platform. So after that, we send the order, we have the position open at market price. Then you see why, if you see this, let me know why the stop loss has moved. Did you see? Did you see? Let me see if we are lucky again and the price is moving up, down, is moving down again. And you see if this line, the stop loss, is gonna move. Why? Good. Mark is answering because you place the trailing stop. Yeah, we place the trailing stop of 22 pips. Okay. But if the market is moving down, the trailing stop is following me. Then, if you want, you can do manually. Now, for example, I want to move the stop loss a little bit here, you have to go on this right side and move and move and move the stop loss where you want. You have several information because you have the price, of course, and then you have the distance in pips related to the market price at the moment, and the euro, how much money you would be losing if your stop loss will be filled. But as you can see, at the very beginning, we decide to risk 200 euros. Now the risk is a little bit lower, and if we move the stop loss here, you know that the risk will be 173.05 euro. That is the 1.73% of the account. This is another information that you don't have in MetaTrader. With this tool, you also have this information that is something more. Now we are making these 23 euros, so we were good in opening this short position. And if you want, you can manage the position from here, just clicking on here, and then you can do in a very fast way with this mini terminal. Okay, you can do the close from here, or what is very useful, the partial close. Maybe I want to close the 1/4 of the position, or half of the position, or 1/3 of the position, or the 10% of the position, or the 90% of the position. I don't know. You can reverse or edge the position directly from here. You can edit the order, and then you will have the windows again. You can manage or close or change the information from here. Now I don't want to change anything. I just want to show you that you can also do this. This is very, 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 very good to have. I can in this moment, this is my account, I can click on break even exit. What is a break even exit? Let's do it. Now, of course, the stop loss is 116.75. So we open the short position at 116.58. Okay. So let's just say that now I want to click on break even exit. My stop loss has been moved to the entry price. So you see now the stop loss is equal to the entry price. So if the now I don't have any risk. Okay, if there is a fast movement with slippage or a gap, of course you can lose now some money, but in the 90%, 99% of the cases, if the market is moving on my favor, I will make some money, some extra money. If the market is coming back to the original point, okay, so there will be a normal retracement, my position will be closed with a profit loss equal to zero. Okay, so this is the break even. Yes, just to answer to Hasan, the session is recorded. I post the recording. I will post tomorrow the recording onto our YouTube channel. So you just have to search for Swissquote channel in YouTube. Then please be reminded that if you want, you can also write to this forex.support at swissquote.com. Okay, so if you don't find the recording on YouTube channel, then this is what I wanted to show, how to manage the risk of the single position directly from the chart, thanks to this mini terminal. Then there are some more settings. If you want to do, you can click here, and then you can work from here, saying that you want to risk the 2% of the equity, and the stop loss will be at this level, or maybe you want a stop loss at the 2% of the equity as well, and the take profit at the 4% of your account. So in this case, the risk reward will be 1 to 1. 1 to 2, sorry. And if you want to add the stop loss or remove it, and if you want to save the template or whatever, but take maybe some minutes in order to work a little bit on this. Now my position has been closed at the break-even level. Did you see? Perfect. So thank you, Hasan. No problem. And that's it. This is the easiest way to manage the risk from the chart. Because a lot of time when it's come to trade, a lot of traders, they just think about the strategies, but you know, money management is very important, it's fundamental. So do not forget to apply in a very in the easiest way that you can. So this is the easiest way that you can, I think. This is my opinion. Perfect. Then next step is to speak about the eye exposure. Eye exposure, it is an indicator that you find when you have the MetaTrader open. For example, now I want to open more and more position on the same currency or products. So for example, dollar yen, let's go down dollar yen. And yeah, this is the eye exposure. I just want to show you, let's say that now I open more and more position on dollar yen. So in this case, I will use the classic way. So now I buy one lot. The first time that you do on the new account, you need to read the disclaimer and if you want to confirm. So in this case, you can click and have the trade filled with one single click. So, and then after different minutes at a different level, we decide to buy again the dollar yen. Okay. And maybe then you decide after 1 hour when you are above the resistance level, 0.75, you decide to short, to sell. Okay. Okay. So in MetaTrader 4, you have one different line for each single position open. Okay, you can do edging, you can close the position from here. Very effective and easy to use and understand. Thanks to this eye exposure indicator, you have the number of the deals that you have, the number of the trades, okay, that you have on this single currency. If you have more currencies or products in your portfolio, you will have a list here of symbols, okay, number of deals, how the sum of the long position that you have at the moment, so 250 lots, and the sum of the sell of the short position that you have, in this case sell lots 0.75, and then the net lots, so the difference between the two position, how many lots you have long minus how many lots you have short. So now my position of the portfolio is 175. The net exposure is 175 lots long. And then you have the profit, okay, PL, profit or loss. And why it is useful, this indicator? Simply because when you open a lot of position of this on the single products, it is then difficult to make the calculation where it is your break even. So your this is the average price. If you make more and more trades, this is the average price. This is your break even level. So at 110.02, you will be closing the position at zero. Okay. And the short position will at zero will be closed at 109.99. So if you are below this level, your short position are making money. If you are above this buy price level, your long position are making money. So this is the average of your position open. Okay. Then there are another information that I give you is there are a lot of traders when they start to trade that they don't care. They say, okay, I don't place the stop loss. But bear in mind that if you don't place the stop loss, you have anyway, you have the same, you have the stop loss, that is the stop out level of your broker. Okay, you know, in the first lesson we already spoke about the margin call and the stop out level. Then you know, margin call and stop out level, they can change over the time also according to the volatility, but at the moment so the 26th of June 2018, okay, the rule of Swissquote about the margin call is that your position will, your portfolio will be in the margin call when the equity will be equal to the margin. Okay, so I want to explain you in a fast way. We already spoke about this, but when it comes to speak about risk management, I think it is important to remember this rule. Margin call. So now this is an account with 10,045 euros, and the margin is 1,500 euros. Okay, the margin is what your broker is keeping in order to keep your position open. Okay, so the margin call will be when the equity and margin will be the same. So now your margin level is 671%. If this number will go to 100%, you are in margin call. Margin call means that your position, you can keep the position open. Okay, it's just a way to say, okay, please be careful. You can send more money if you want, or please manage your position. So you can totally close or partially close. So now we are making money on dollar yen, and now I want to close the position. Okay. So please be careful. You can send money or you can manage the position that you have. Maybe you want to close them or you want to partially close them, you can do. Okay. But you cannot increase the exposure of your portfolio. So if you are long on dollar yen and you want to add more position long on dollar yen, you cannot do with the margin call. If this level, the ratio between equity and margin will be lower than 30%. So in our first example, the margin was 1,500. And the 30% of this value is 450,000. So if your equity will become equal or lower respect this amount, your position can be closed starting from the position that is losing more money at that moment. Okay. But of course, you just have to need how this rule works, and you don't usually you should not be in the condition of having the margin call or the stop out level. So, but bear in mind that if you don't place the stop loss on your position, there is a stop loss that it is the stop out level of the broker. So, manage the position by yourself. So, place the stop loss when you open a position, please, or do it afterwards, but you have to know what you are doing. And Mini Terminal, this tool is helping you out in doing this risk management in a proper way, in my opinion. Now, I would like to show you, before speaking about the average true range and standard deviation, I would like to show you this tab. That is the exposure tab. A lot of people, they know how to use this trade. So now here you have, when you come to trade, you have the open position on the first tab and the account history where you can find the statement of your account, the history of your account. So you move from trade account to account history, and a lot of people, they don't use the exposure of the MetaTrader. And if you have just one or two positions open, it's fine. You don't need this information you already have. But if you have a portfolio with 5, 10, 20 positions on currency, it is very helpful in order to manage all the risk of the whole portfolio. And I just have some slide about this. Exposure tab. So I just want to show you the exposure tab. This is the definition on MetaQuotes website. The exposure tab contains the summary information about the state of assets by all open position. So in this case, we have we have a different position open on four currencies: Australian dollar, Swiss franc, euro, and dollar. Okay, and then you see the overall exposure of the portfolio. So in this case, you can understand from the blue lines at the right that the exposure is mostly on euro and dollar in a long position. Anyway, we will see from the MetaTrader in 30 seconds. The information is displayed in the form of a table that contains the following fields. Sorry, there is another. Would you please clarify what does apply for MT5 for the points that you have explained? Everything, but not the Swissquote tool, the Swissquote mini terminal, the Swissquote trading. At the moment, they are available only for MT4. All the rest, for example, the exposure and what I say in terms of risk management, of course, they are available for MT5. And we spoke a lot about MT4, MT5, and the differences between the two platforms in the lesson number two and the lesson number three, and even the lesson number four. So, in this case, the difference is that the Swissquote tools that we start to offer now, that I'm explaining you, the mini terminal and all the others that we saw, they are not available in MT5 at the moment. So, only in MT4, that is the most commonly used platform. So let's explain what you can find in the exposure tab. The name of the asset, of course, the volume of a client's position in units by the given position considering leverage, the rate of currency or symbol to the deposit currency, and the deposit currency and the diagram, the graph. Now I switch directly to the platform so we will understand what we said here. Okay, so now let's open positions. I already opened once on the dollar yen, so now of course my exposure is on the yen. You have the diagram here at the right, so you can click on the diagram. And you have the long position, you can switch to the short position. How many short position I have now? I just bought. I bought the dollar yen, so my short position is just on the yen. Okay, of course. The long position has two different colors and two different currencies because I have a long position on the dollars, but my account is in euro. This is an information that for me was better not to have because makes sense. But who program the programmer of MetaQuotes or the programmer of MetaTrader, they prefer to insert. The point is that if your account is in euro and the euro is losing the value, of course the value of the account is reducing. I have another idea because I would like to compare all the portfolio. I was going compared to my base currency. Anyway, they programmed the MetaTrader, not me. So this is the final decision that they took. But what I need now is that you just understand this. So in the first line, in the first column, in the first column, the very first, you have the name of the asset, of course. So in this case, euro, yen, or dollar. If I close the position, just to let you understand better. You see, my basic currency of this account is in euro, so my full exposure is in euro. This is the balance, the equity, the equity of this account, $10,108. Euros, sorry, 10,108 euros. And this is the rate. Of course, there is no. The rate between euro and euro is 1.0. So if I have dollar, it will be a different rate. And this is the volume. It is a sort of buying power. So it is the real money that we have on our account multiplied by the leverage. Okay. So now I'm opening again this position on dollar yen. And what happened? That it happened that I have $100,000 onto my account. Okay, this is the exchanging rate compared to my base currency that is euro. Okay, and why is 0.859? Simply because the rate of euro dollar at the moment is 1.1640. So if you need $1,640 in order to get 1 euro, you will need 1 divided x. Okay, so you will need 0.8591 euros to get a dollar. Okay, So this is the reason why the rate is in this way. And so we have $100,000 long. So you see also the blue line here at the right. Okay, this one. And we sold this number of JPY, Japanese yen, okay, at this exchange rate compared to the euro. So now I'm long on dollar, short on Japanese yen. If you don't want to have this diagram, maybe you can just hide it. Okay. I think with the bars is fine. You understand better how long you are or how short you are. So, Hans, if you have just one position, it's not the biggest information, the most useful information that we need. But if you start to have more and more and more position, let's go now. For example, now I want to increase my position in dollars, so I have to, my long position in dollars. So now I'm going to sell the cable. Now I'm going to buy the Kiwi and the USD. Okay, the Aussie. I will buy the Aussie dollar against USD dollar, US dollar. Okay, so. Now I balance my position a little bit more because now overall my exposure in dollar is still good. Is not that high. I was short. Now I'm long of 89,000. Okay, but if I start to, let's say that I start to sell too many dollars. So I open a long position dollar, euro dollar. If I buy euro dollar, it means that I'm buying euro and selling dollars. So then I sell the dollar yen, two lots. Then I buy the cable, so I buy the pound selling the dollars. Okay. So you start to see that your overall position is too much. In terms of exposing, in terms of the exposure against the dollar. So, if the dollar will lose, will be fine. So you will make a lot of money on the dollar. But the point is that if you are making too much, if the dollar will be appreciating. You will be losing too much money. So for this reason, it's very good and very effective to monitor this exposure on the MetaTrader in this way. So the tab exposure is very effective when you start to have a lot of position on currencies. Okay. Last step, and then we finish this presentation, is to give you, to provide you some more information regarding how, when, where to place your stop loss. Stop loss and or take profits, but in this case we will be speaking more about stop loss. Just 2 minutes about these two indicators that I want to show you, that are the average true range, and then we will be speaking about the standard deviation. So let me close all the other indicator and this exposure. Let me know if you have any question about this exposure tab that MetaTrader offers to you. So this is the cable, okay, and we are looking at the 15-minute chart. The volatility of the moment is 12 pips, okay. So what is average true range? Average true range is simply the average of the distance between the high and the low of the last 14 candles. In this case, simply because the indicator is with 14 here. So if you want to change this number of candles, you can do from here. Okay. So this is the average volatility of the market. Okay. Then let me add now the very famous Bollinger Bands. So what is Bollinger? what are the Bollinger Bands? Bollinger Bands, you have the simple moving average and two standard deviation. Okay, let's go with one standard deviation because now I want to show you how does it work. So the standard deviation in this case in GBP/USD 15 minute chart is just the difference between the moving average and the band. Okay, so you have 8 pips. Okay, and the movement of one standard deviation is very common. So it is 68% of probability that the GBP/USD in the next 15 minutes will be moving 8 pips up or 8 pips down. So when it comes to place a stop loss, please do not insert your stop loss inside this level. So if you are trading a 15-minute chart, at least 8 pips. If you are trading a 4-hour chart, at least the standard deviation at the moment is 17 pips. Okay. So if you are trading on a 4-hour chart, the GBP/USD, and you place the stop loss at 5 pips, the probability that the level will be taken is extremely high. So don't do it. Okay. Azan is asking, suppose that I have multiple position open in the same time, what's your recommendation for maximum risk allow as percentage from the account for all the position combined? This is an amazing question because it is up also to the exposure. For this reason I explained the exposure. The point is that if you have multiple position, but you don't have this problem that I'm having at the moment with the great exposure on the dollars, but you have a more balanced portfolio, this will be not a problem, because if you maybe lose money on one position, the other position that is decorrelated will make money. Okay, but if you have this problem, for this reason I show you the exposure of a MetaTrader, okay, you will lose. Maybe if you risk the 1% of one position, the 1% on the other position, the 1% on the other position, but if your portfolio is extremely correlated, if one position will go to the stop loss, all the other position probably will go to the stop loss, so you will lose the 10%, so you will lose 10 times the 1%. So for this reason it's very important to look at the exposure of the MetaTrader when you have more than 3 positions open, let's say. Okay, then I also want to show you this, as long as you are asking this amazing question. We have in this new tool that we offer, we have this tool that is showing you the correlation matrix. That is not the moving matrix, but is the matrix that is showing you the correlation between currencies. So you can change the time frame from here. Let's go for the daily correlation. Let's go for the 200 bars correlation. And now I want to highlight the strongest correlation. So those are the stronger correlation on the market now, for example, of course, between Nasdaq and Dow Jones, because I selected these those ones. So this list is according to the portfolio that you created, okay? But when you come to trade currencies, it's very important, very effective to watch at the correlation that you have. So if you have a positive correlation between the GBP/USD and euro dollar, for example, and you are long bought on GBP/USD and euro dollar, of course the risk of your portfolio will be high. Anyway, you will also get this information from the exposure tab that we just explained. Okay, but the question, thank you for the question. We will be speaking more about this new tool that we offer, but so far I explain all that I want to explain during this presentation, so I'm pretty happy. Yeah, perfect. So you will be finding this expert advisor and indicators If you ask to my colleagues writing to Forex support, as I showed you before, this is the mail again, forex.support@swissquote.com, in order to get all these new tools that we offer. While trading Forex with Swissquote, we have more than 20 years of online trading expertise, trusted by more than 300,000 traders worldwide, and we are listed on the Swiss exchange, and our capitalization at the moment is around 750 million Swiss francs, so you can trust in us. We are regulated by FINMA here in Switzerland. Are you ready to start trading with Swissquote? We offer you the news and exclusive market research throughout the day. You can use our MT4, MT5, or Advanced Trader platform. We spoke about our proprietary platform that is Advanced Trader in the lesson number 5 last week. You can find on the playlist on the YouTube. And in the other lesson, included this one, we spoke about MT4 and MT5. Please bear in mind that these new tools that we offer are compatible only with MT4, that is the most commonly used MetaTrader. Also, if you decide to use MT4 or Advanced Trader, you can also have one account in MT4. Maybe you want to use Expert Advisor Trading System, and you can use Advanced Trader as well. So you can have multiple accounts with us. So as long as you're following this mastering trading, I already know you, some of you, so some of you are already clients, but if you are not a client of Swissquote, please at least download the demo of the platform that you wish, okay, and then you don't have no risk, no obligations. Please bear in mind our contact, +41 44 825 8777. Opening hours are from 8 a.m. to 10 p.m. Monday to Friday. Our website is swissquote.com and forex.support@swissquote.com. Again, our mailing. Thank you very much. Please take your time in order to read the disclaimer. Please bear in mind that CFDs and Forex are leverage product. So please ensure you understand all the risk before trading. Thank you very much. Yeah, I will be sending you the recording, but bear in mind that you can find the Swissquote channel on YouTube. We have some recording of the last webinars, and we have the playlist of mastering trading. So if you want to watch the previous lessons, starting from the lesson number 1, coming to the lesson number 6, please go to YouTube looking for Swissquote playlist of mastering trading. Thank you very much.